Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam. My brothers and sisters in Islam, during many calamities that happened to this ummah, that you will find the people, they will spread different fatawa and different advices amongst them. These fatawa and these advices did not come from the scholars of Islam. It came from ignorant people, people who doesn't follow the guidelines of the Quran and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to issue these fatawas. And where Allah Azza wa Jalla has made a fundamental principle in the Quran that we should refer back to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to the people who are in charge amongst us, who are the scholars of Islam, to give us the right understanding. Allah Azza wa Jalla has mentioned this in the Quran in Surah An-Nisa, verse number 83. Allah stated in the Quran, وَإِذَا جَاءَهُمْ أَمْرٌ مِنَ الْأَمْنِ أَوَ الْخَوْفِ أَذَاعُوا بِهِ. If the matters of public safety or matters of fear came to them, then they will spread rumors about it. Where Allah has said, what is the solution? وَلَوْ رَدُّوهُ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ وَإِلَى أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْهُمْ لَعَلَمُهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِطُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ. If they refer it back to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to the people who are in charge amongst them, who are the scholars, then the people who have the right understanding will give them the right way and the right advice. So here Allah Azza wa Jalla is telling us in these calamities that we should return back and we should refer back to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and we should refer back to the scholars of Islam to give us the right advice. And nowadays we'll find the people, they came to us during this fitna, the fitna of coronavirus, the people, they will spread different fatawa and different things they will do. Let's do together takbir. And I saw, for example, one of the clips that one of the Muslim countries, they were doing takbir together. They said in Italy, they're singing together, we should do takbir together and we should do tasbih together. And even some people, they say, let's do fasting, for example, certain days together. And some people, they will say, let's do qiyam al-layl, for example, a certain point, and ask Allah Azza wa Jal, then Allah Azza wa Jal help us during this calamity. Subhanallah. All of these things, these are from the innovation. These are bid'ah. This is the bid'ah. These are innovation in Islam. Where our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said clearly in the hadith, he said alayhi salatu wa sallam, man ahdatha fi amrina hadha ma laysa minhu fahuwa rad. Whoever invented something which is not from Islam, then it is rejected. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Man amila amalan laysa alayhi amruna fahuwa rad." Whoever acted any act which doesn't follow our guidelines, then it is rejected. Here our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us that we should not innovate anything, we should not add anything to the deen of Islam. And Allah Azza wa Jalla has stated as well clearly in the Quran, "Am lahum shuraka'u shara'u lahum min ad-din ma lam ya'dhan Allah." That Allah, do they have partners like as divine to legislate for them? From the matters of deen, from the matters of our faith, which Allah did not permit, subhanallah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stated clearly in the hadith, كل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Every innovation is misguidance, and every misguidance will lead to the hellfire. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said as well in the hadith, كل بدعة ضلالة وإن رآها الناس حسنة. Every innovation is misguidance, even if the people, they see it as something good. Where we find even the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they implemented the guidelines of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they implemented what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said. Where Abdullah bin Mas'ud, when he came and he found people in the masjid, they are doing tasbih together, what he said to them, he said, "Ma asra halakatakum," he said, "you haste to destruction," he was saying to them. And then they said, "Ma aranna illa khayran ya Aba Abdurrahman," we only want good, or Abdullah or Aba Abdurrahman, which is Abdullah bin Mas'ud. Then he said to them, "Kam muridin lil khayri la yudruku," that many people who wants good, that they will not achieve it, subhanallah. And even one of the greatest scholars of Islam, Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, rahimahullah, he is the one who explained Bukhari. And he wrote one of the books, it's called Badl al-Ma'un fi Fadl al-Ta'un, which means putting efforts to talk about the favors of the plague. So he's talking about the favors of the plague, and as well he wrote as well many of the ruling and many of the things that in related to the matters of the plague when it happened. And then he said one of the things he mentioned, he said when some people they get together to do ibadah together, they do dhikr together, some of them they said they fasted together, and some of them they said let's go to the outskirts of the city and let's make dua together, and so on and so forth. And he said all of these are innovation in Islam. And subhanallah, and he said one of the places when the plague happened in that place, what he said about it, he said the numbers of the deceased one, the number of the death in that area, it was much, much less. It was only around in a day around 40 people in a day. He said after they start innovating in deen, then they gain Allah's anger. And then the people, he said, the number increased to become nearly 1,000 people in a day. Subhanallah. And that's why we need to understand, my brothers and sisters, that the bid'ah is greater than even major sins. To innovate something in deen is greater than committing a major sin. Wal-iyadu billah. And that's why one of the scholars as well, of the Hanafi scholars, like for example Ibn Abdin and another scholar, his name is Ibn Nujaym al-Hanafi rahimahumullah, both of them, they approved what Ibn Hajar rahimahullah has mentioned about the ruling related to the plague. So my brothers and sisters, our faith is complete and we don't need anything to add, and we should follow the guidelines of the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we should stay at home most of our time and not to leave our houses except if there is a necessity, that's all. Otherwise we stay at home with our families, we pray together with our families, we make dua together with our families, and this is what we should do as a duties for us as Muslims. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to remove this calamity from the world, and we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to cure those ones who have this disease and all other diseases, and we ask Allah to protect us and to protect our families and our loved ones and our friends from these diseases. Wa jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
أشهد أن لا